Optimizing a PV system is not a trivial problem. Factors such as design goals and design constraints must be considered. In this tutorial, we will demonstrate how to use the optimization tool to aid you in making these design decisions. The optimization tool allows you to vary a set of up to 3 input parameters and monitor different output parameters. Here are the input and output parameters available when using the optimization tool. The tool will run a scan on different values of your input parameters and compare the output parameters. In this tutorial, we will show you how to use this tool to analyze the effect of changing the tilt and pitch on the performance of a system. Let's start by creating our system. We will model the system on the demo residential project in Geneva. Open VC0 and save a new variant. We will call this variant Sheds Optimization. Change the orientation to Unlimited Sheds. Leave the other parameters as they are now. Instead of running the simulation, we will now use the optimization tool. Click on Advanced Simulation. Click on Optimization Tool. First, choose a name for the scan. In our case, we will call this scan Pitch and Tilt Optimization. In the first tab, you can choose your input parameters. In our case, we are going to use pitch and tilt. For each parameter, you can then choose the range and number of steps for the scan. In our case, let's use 4 values between 5 degrees and 35 degrees for the tilt. And we can use every pitch between 5 and 10 meters with steps of exactly 1 meter. For that, we will need to use 6 steps. Running this optimization will run 24 full simulations of a year using hourly weather data. Click Run to run the simulations. After the first simulation is run, the time estimate is more reliable. This estimate will vary depending on the power of the machine. Once the optimization scan is finished, you are brought to the View Results tab. Here, you can select different output variables and see the value of that output variable as a function of the input parameters of your scan. By default, you are shown E-Grid, which is the amount of energy injected into the grid over the whole year. However, you can change these variables. Using SHD loss, for example, you can see how much energy is lost due to shading. As you may expect, a smaller pitch and larger tilt angle result in more shading losses. In this system, we have not defined economic parameters. However, if you have performed an economic simulation, you can look at the economic results of the simulation with LCOE and payback period. There are also tools to customize this plot. By default, you can see the pitch on the x-axis and the tilt on the y-axis. However, these can be swapped. Alternatively, you can also look at 1D plots of a particular variable. In this case, we are looking at E-grid with respect to tilt only. When you do this, you need to define a constant value for your other input parameters. You can do this using the slider or the arrow buttons. Finally, there are some options for the plot display. First, you can choose to display the maximum on the plot or not. The next option allows you to show the full range for the plot among all data points or not. When selected, the y-axis stays fixed among all the plots using the full range of data points throughout the scan. When deselected, each plot will use its individual maximum and minimum values to set the y-axis limits. When you are finished with your scan, click OK to close the scan. PVSYST will prompt you to save your variant. If you save your variant here, all of these results will be saved to the variant, and you'll be able to see them again. To see old scans in a variant, go back to Advanced Simulation and click on Optimization Tool. Click on View Results and make sure that your scan is selected from the drop-down menu. In this tutorial, we showed you how to use the optimization tool to observe output parameters from a scan of input parameters. This tool can help you make design decisions for your system. However, it does present some limitations as it only allows you to use the most common input and output parameters. For full freedom of choice of input and output parameters, you can use the batch simulation. Using the batch simulation will be covered in another tutorial.